Welcome to another video. Here we are going to explain what is drive cycle, different types of drive cycles, and how to create one drive cycle for electric vehicle simulation. In some of our previous videos, we mentioned the word driving cycle. If you are going to do electric vehicle related projects, then driving cycles are important. I hope these videos would help the people who are willing to do electric vehicle research projects. If you are here for the first time, we create videos about electric vehicle technology, electric vehicle projects, news, reviews, etc. Please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon to get notified when we publish every single video about electric vehicle. First of all, what is driving cycle? A driving cycle is a set of values, generally velocity versus time, which represents how a vehicle travels through a path. In simple words, it is a velocity versus time graph of a vehicle. It would be different for different regions. For example, the driving at city traffic and highways could be different. Why do we need a driving cycle? The main uses of driving cycles are to assess the performance of a vehicle, to analyze the battery performance and energy consumption of electric vehicles, to simulate the vehicle models prior to the actual development. It is important. The vehicles are developed and designed using selecting the components optimally. If an electric vehicle is considered, the selection of motor, power electronic components, battery and mechanical parts involves calculation and optimization to reduce the losses in terms of energy and cost. A vehicle model is simulated in simulation software prior to the actual development to get the performance of the vehicle. In electric vehicle, the energy that stored in the battery of the EV is transferred to the wheels through converter, motor and gear. Usually every components in an electric vehicle are mathematically modeled in simulation software. Energy consumption, battery performance, etc. are analyzed by simulating the model. In one video, we explained about the free MATLAB Graphic User Interface Advisor that you could use for simulation of electric vehicles. Two types of models are generally used for electric vehicle simulations: backward facing model and forward facing model. Backward facing simulation calculates the energy consumption at each stage of the vehicle, assuming the drive path of the vehicle is known. That is, the driving cycle will be applied at the wheels of the simulation model of the vehicle, and back calculates the energy consumption at each stage, such as inverter, motor, battery, etc. Next, we are going to check out different types of driving cycles. The driving cycles can be classified as model driving cycles and transient driving cycles. The model driving cycle is a synthetic driving cycle that doesn't actually represent a real driving pattern. These driving cycles are generally used for some specific applications, such as emission test. New European Driving Cycle, NEDC, is an example for a model driving cycle. The second one is transient driving cycle. The transient driving cycle represents the actual driving pattern of vehicle that consists of acceleration, deceleration, constant speed, etc. The federal test procedure is an example of a transient driving cycle. The city driving cycles will have a lot of accelerations, decelerations, stops, etc. And highway drive cycles will have constant or high speed for a long time. How to develop a driving cycle? Why do we develop a drive cycle that specific to a region? The reason is that the traffic and road conditions will not be same in all regions. Vehicle manufacturers use standard driving cycles that have already been developed for performance analysis and testing of the vehicle. That might be different from the actual drive pattern of the vehicle where they are supposed to drive. If you are planning to release a vehicle on Indian road conditions, then it would be better to test the vehicle on Indian drive cycles that best represents the driving pattern. Selection and optimization of motor, power electronic components, battery, etc. can be possible with respect to the region where the vehicle is going to use. If you are doing a research project on electric vehicle, then you can consider creating a drive cycle specific to your region. Driving cycles for city, highways, rural area, or any region can be developed using different techniques. The generic steps involved are the following. The first step is route selection. Select the route where the drive cycle to be developed. based on the application of the cycle. For example, the performance of the vehicle in a city can be analyzed using the drive cycle created specifically for the city. In this case, we can select the city as the region where we are going to develop drive cycle. The routes must represent the actual selected area as much as possible. Biased results can be avoided selecting the routes properly. The step 2 is data collection. A large quantity of data is required to develop a generalized drive cycle of a region. A single trip data would not replicate the generic pattern of the driving in that region. The data collection for driving cycle development can be done in different methods. The common techniques of data collection are vehicle chase and onboard instrumentation. In vehicle chase method, a vehicle with data collection equipment follows another vehicle whose data has to be collected. The following vehicle records the data for the preceding vehicle. Obviously, the collected data varies since the succeeding vehicle cannot replicate the behavior of the predecessor vehicle. In onboard instrumentation method, instrument for data collection will be installed on many vehicles and they record data from themselves. This is a recommended method for data collection. This method will help to get exact data from the vehicles. Large quantity of data in real-time traffic situation would show a trend that would follow a pattern. The data depends on factors such as age group of driver, emotional state, time of day, road conditions, gender, etc. In some cases, the data collection lasts around 5 years. The third step is data classification. In this step, ample data that have been collected will be consolidated and classified for further processing. Create microtrip data, dividing the whole distance that covered by the vehicle into small segments. Microtrips can be generated dividing the data into small start-stop segments. They can be equal time segments or speed range segments as well. The fourth step is drive cycle construction. In the third step, we develop microtrips using collected data. The next step is to refine the trips for the selection of candidate points for the driving cycles. From the microtrip data, remove the odd data point sets and derive a general pattern. A drive cycle will have some reference parameters: minimum speed, maximum speed, average speed, speed acceleration probability distribution, speed acceleration frequency distribution, etc. After removing the odd data points, the drive cycle can be constructed combining the microtrips. The reference parameters of the constructed drive cycle should be matched with the whole data that collected. Then only we can say that the constructed drive cycle represents the actual collected data. The quantity of the collected data will be huge and our drive cycle will not exceed some 30 or 60 minutes. The best driving cycle will be the one which will have the parameters equal to the parameters of the collected data. Here we briefly explained the process to develop a driving cycle. I hope this helps you. Drop your thoughts in the comments and remember to subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching this video.